Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra. And in Shiksha Mantra today we have something very much special. And what's that special? What we are going to discuss today, it's really very much interesting. When you learn a lot about something, it means you are gathering information. This is directly related to know many new things and also many new grammatical terms. So today, here, you must subscribe my Telegram channel to get the notes of these videos. And the link is in the description box. So follow my Shiksha Mantra channel, subscribe it in Telegram, and you'd get everything, whatever is there in the form of notes or PDF. So let's see what's waiting there for us today. Yes, it's verbs. Really, verbs have so many very different types that actually most of the time you get confused. Sometimes you feel, really, how many types of verbs are there? So many different types of verbs, how to handle them? But here we are going to present something extraordinary. Let's learn some of the verbs of which we have heard so little. They are used in our language but so very silently that they stay almost obscured. The time has come to unearth them to our students. Really, if you feel this, you must know a lot of things. And when you know a lot of terms and terminologies in English grammar, it would supply you some form of confidence, and this confidence again support your learning. So let's see, here comes the first of them. Tell me if you have heard of this verb before. Write it in the comment below. Okay, pause the video, write it down, and we would shift to our next slide. That is, we are going to declare what's the verb. This verb is called incoative verbs or incentive verbs. So what are they? Let's check it out. So where has it come from? This is our first question. So we must learn its origin. It is mostly used in Latin, Greek and ancient Roman languages. There it is used as a special tense. It adds a yummy flavor to your sentences. Now you may ask, what's the definition for this verb? It shows a process of beginning or becoming. So it says what? It shows a gradual development and it describes a change of state. So when it's a process of beginning or becoming, that means from somewhere it makes a journey. It suggests a journey. So that is a gradual development or also a change of state. In course of our example, we'd find out how it makes them. But you must remember that it's a process of beginning or becoming. It shows a gradual development and it describes a change of state. And here we have some other questions. What form do these verbs get? In English, the incoative verbs are usually formed by adding the suffix -en with a verb. It also signified by the verbs ending in -ify. So, here we have some examples. The mangoes ripened. The mangoes ripened. We were talking about the change of state. So what does this mean? It means the mangoes became ripe. So there's a change of state from green to ripen. So this is what we do with the incoative verbs like ripen. There's another. He has aged a lot. Has aged a lot. It means he has become old. That's also a change of state. That's also a gradual development. And this is what we call incoative verbs. This other will glorify the institution. So the institution will get glorified. So that's how it goes, the gradual development. Do you have a special example? Yes, we have a very special example here. If you follow this example, you'd understand everything, every fact regarding incoative verbs. The research paper I bought say that according to the ancient alchemists, the soul had to go through a transformative process through which it would blacken, whiten and redden in turn. So it would blacken, whiten and redden. So these are the incoative verbs. And here it suggests a transformative process. So a gradual development, a transformation of state. That's what our incoative verbs or inceptive verbs say. So let's see what's waiting for us. Now summarize, please. Yes, we have to summarize the things here. And the summarization comes here. In English, we manage them with become, get, etc. Like it's getting dark. So it means it's darkening. It's getting dark means it's darkening. So we manage them with become or get. Here comes second point. The verbs are intransitive in meaning and occur without a direct object. So this is intransitive and without a direct object. And there's the third one. Don't forget that it makes a change of state. Now it's time to like, share and subscribe. Shiksha Mantra. Bye-bye. Happy learning. Stay tuned. We are coming with many such verbs which probably you have listened for the very first time. So wait, we are coming right back.